All right, everybody, welcome to today's Catch and Field Friday. I wanted to go over something that I still see a little bit in high school baseball and with some of the old school coaches. And that's to me, it's the difference between a crow hop and the shuffle behind or the step behind throw. And why I prefer the step behind and why the crow hop has sort of eliminated itself from Major League Baseball. So essentially, the old school teaching is, right, we want to get a big old crow hop. We want to really jump off that back leg. And you know, we want to feel that ball. We want to pick a big jump, right? Well, the issue with that is, as humans, we can create our most force from the ground. And if I use that force to jump up, I then have to then catch myself, which takes time to then balance, and I can't use my energy to drive and make my throw towards my target. Instead, I then have to like catch myself and then go forward, and I've lost some of my power. Whereas when I step behind, I can then still build momentum towards my target, and I can get some lower half movement going, and I can use the ground more effectively to drive into my throw. And I see that a lot with some of the kids we have coming in. They're taking these big old crow hops and trying to throw, and what happens is you're just not using the ground as effectively as you could. And you can, if you don't believe me, look up Mike Trout, look up Yasiel Puig, you won't see a crow hop. Right? The outfielders with the strongest arms, they don't crow hop anymore. They step behind with a little shuffle behind throw. Reason being, more contact with the ground, they can create more force. That's all I've got for today. If you want more content, check us out at www.trainerprime.com.